Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. Quest for the Lost Bow of Zeus. Chapter 1. The Call of Olympus. In the heart of Greece, where the rugged landscapes and timeless myths converged, a brave adventurer named Alexios felt the allure of a quest that resonated with the very essence of legend, the search for the elusive bow of Zeus. Nestled in the vales of the formidable Mount Olympus, the epicenter of divine affairs, this mythical artifact was said to be a conduit to the powers of the king of gods himself. As the sun cast its golden glow over the ancient land, Alexios stood at the foothills of Mount Olympus, the air tinged with the scent of laurels and the echoes of ancient prophecies. His armor, crafted with care and adorned with symbols of valor, reflected the determination etched on his face. With a map drawn from fragments of cryptic scrolls and tales of seers, he embarked on a journey that would test not only his physical prowess, but also the depths of his character. The ascent into the hidden valleys of Olympus was no ordinary trek. It was a pilgrimage through landscapes alive with the whispers of gods and the footsteps of heroes. Ancient temples, half buried in the verdant foliage, hinted at the bow's existence, serving as signposts in this sacred quest. The path ahead, winding through emerald forests and meadows adorned with blossoms, felt like a passage through the living tapestry of myth. Alexios's journey, however, was not solitary. Companions, drawn by the allure of the divine artifact, joined him in his pursuit. Among them was the skilled archer Callista, her eyes reflecting a blend of determination and awe as she prepared for the challenges that lay ahead. Together, they formed a fellowship bound by a shared purpose: to unlock the secrets guarded by the bow of Zeus. As they ventured deeper into the heart of Olympus, the air seemed to shimmer with an ethereal energy. Mythical creatures, guardians of the ancient realms, appeared on the periphery of their vision. Centaurs patrolling the edges of sacred groves, griffins soaring through the azure skies, and nymphs dancing in the cascading waters of hidden springs. Each encounter, a testament to the intertwining of the mortal and divine, hinted at the impending trials that awaited the intrepid adventurers. The verdant landscapes soon gave way to sheer cliffs and craggy peaks as they ascended toward the summit. The distant echoes of thunder resonated through the mountains, a reminder of the celestial presence that watched over the hallowed grounds. As they pressed forward, the ancient stones seemed to hum with stories of the gods' interactions with mortals, and the very ground beneath their feet whispered the secrets of Zeus's bow. The journey was not without challenges. Mystical barriers, remnants of ancient curses, guarded the entrances to divine sanctuaries. At one such threshold, the fellowship faced a riddle posed by the spirit of an oracle, a puzzle that required not only intellect, but an understanding of the intricate connections between mortals and immortals. Callista, with her sharp mind and knowledge of ancient lore, deciphered the enigma, allowing the fellowship to progress deeper into the mythic realms. The first true test awaited them in the Valley of Trials, a realm bathed in the glow of celestial energies. The valley, guarded by the majestic Chimera, presented a formidable challenge. Its lion head roared, its serpent tail hissed, and its goat head gazed with malevolent intent. The clash between mortal steel and mythical might echoed through the valley as Alexios, Callista, and their companions engaged the mythical beast. The battle was fierce, and the air crackled with the interplay of magic and might. Alexios, with his sword and shield, faced the lion's roar and the serpent's venom, while Callista unleashed a volley of arrows to keep the goat head at bay. The fellowship's determination, fueled by the shared vision of unlocking the powers of Zeus's bow, proved to be the catalyst for victory. As the Chimera dissipated into ethereal wisps, the valley bore witness to the triumph of mortals over mythic challenges. The victory in the Valley of Trials marked a turning point in their quest, strengthening the bonds between the adventurers and imbuing them with a sense of purpose that resonated with the divine. As they ascended higher, the landscape transformed into an ethereal realm where the very air shimmered with divine radiance. The summit of Olympus, cloaked in celestial mists, beckoned them closer, promising revelations and trials that transcended the boundaries of mortal understanding. At the threshold of the celestial summit, where the heavens seemed to touch the earth, Alexios and his companions gazed upon a celestial portal. It pulsed with an otherworldly glow, a gateway to the heart of divine realms. The fellowship, united by the challenges faced and the victories won, stepped through the portal, ready to confront the celestial guardian that stood between them and the legendary Bow of Zeus. As they passed through the portal, the very fabric of reality seemed to ripple with the energies of Olympus. The adventure had brought them to the brink of mythic revelation, and the echoes of ancient prophecies resonated in the air. The celestial summit awaited, promising not only the fulfillment of their quest, but a confrontation with the essence of divine power itself. The call of Olympus, now louder than ever, propelled Alexios and his companions into the heart of the celestial realms, where mortal determination would clash with the celestial forces guarding the legendary Bow of Zeus. Chapter 2, Creatures of Myth and Mystic Curses. The celestial portal transported Alexios and his companions to a realm where the very air seemed to shimmer with ethereal energy. The celestial summit of Olympus, bathed in a celestial glow, unfolded before them like a tapestry woven with the threads of divine magic. Yet, the challenges that lay ahead were far from over. As they traversed the summit, the fellowship encountered mythical beings that seemed to materialize from the very fabric of ancient tales. Majestic griffins soared through the crystalline skies, their wings casting shadows over the celestial landscape. Centaurs, wise and enigmatic, patrolled the pathways, their hooves echoing on the celestial stone. The fellowship's path led them to the Garden of Nymphs, a sanctuary where ethereal maidens danced amidst blossoms that bloomed in hues unseen in the mortal realm. The nymphs, guardians of divine secrets, greeted the adventurers with a melodic hymn that echoed through the celestial garden. Callista, with her knowledge of ancient customs, joined the nymphs in a dance that mirrored the cosmic harmony of the celestial realms, earning the fellowship the nymphs' favor. As they journeyed deeper into the celestial realms, they encountered the elusive harpies, winged creatures with talons sharp as the arrows they sought to protect. The harpies, sentinels of the cosmic winds, tested the fellowship's agility and precision. Alexios, his reflexes honed through countless battles, engaged in an aerial ballet with the harpies, their wings creating gusts that stirred the very fabric of the celestial air. The celestial summit revealed not only mythical creatures, but also the remnants of ancient curses that sought to thwart the unworthy. A labyrinth woven with threads of destiny awaited them. Its walls seemed to shift and morph, an ever-changing puzzle that challenged their resolve. Callista, drawing inspiration from the tales of Theseus and the Minotaur, guided the fellowship through the labyrinth's twists and turns, unveiling the secrets of the cosmic maze. In the heart of the labyrinth, they encountered a sphinx, an enigmatic being with the body of a lion and the wings of an eagle. The sphinx, guardian of celestial knowledge, posed a riddle that transcended mortal comprehension. The answer, hidden within the layers of ancient wisdom, required a synthesis of intellect and intuition. Callista, with her ability to unravel the threads of cryptic lore, deciphered the riddle, earning the fellowship the Sphinx's blessing and the passage to the next phase of their celestial odyssey. The celestial summit, however, held not only trials, but also moments of celestial beauty. At the Mirror Lake, its waters reflecting the constellations above, the fellowship witnessed the arrival of Pegasus, the celestial winged steed born from the blood of the slain Medusa. Pegasus, with wings outstretched, offered its back to the adventurers, carrying them across the celestial expanse in a journey that transcended the boundaries of mortal travel. As they soared through the cosmic currents, the fellowship beheld the grandeur of Olympus from a vantage point that seemed to touch the very heavens. The radiant glow of the celestial landscape unfolded beneath them, revealing the interconnected realms of the gods and the destinies woven in the tapestry of the cosmos. Yet, amidst the celestial beauty, mystic challenges continued to test their mettle. The River Styx, a celestial tributary, flowed with waters that held the essence of cosmic memory. To cross its currents, the fellowship faced spectral apparitions that embodied the sorrows and regrets of the past. Alexios, with a heart fortified by the experiences of his journey, navigated the river's depths, guiding his companions through the ethereal currents. The celestial summit culminated in the astral Colosseum, a realm where the echoes of past and future battles reverberated through the celestial air. Here, the fellowship faced astral warriors, spectral champions conjured by the very essence of Olympus. The battles were not merely physical. They were a dance of celestial energies, a clash of divine forces that mirrored the cosmic struggles of the gods themselves. The fellowship, tested by mythical creatures, labyrinthine puzzles, celestial riddles, and spectral battles, emerged from the astral Colosseum with a sense of unity and celestial empowerment. Their journey through the celestial summit had not only strengthened their bonds, but also honed their spirits to face the ultimate confrontation with the guardian of the Bow of Zeus. As they stood at the threshold of the final phase of their quest, the celestial energies resonated within them, echoing the cosmic symphony of Olympus. The fellowship, now attuned to the very pulse of the celestial realms, prepared to confront the celestial guardian, a being forged from the essence of thunder and lightning, a force that embodied the might and majesty of the King of Gods. The celestial portal, shimmering with divine radiance, awaited them. Alexios and his companions, their spirits alight with celestial energy, stepped through the portal, ready to face the guardian and unlock the powers of the legendary Bow of Zeus. The celestial summit, with its mythical creatures, mystic challenges, and celestial beauty, had become the crucible that forged them into heroes worthy of standing against the forces that guarded the essence of Olympus. The call of the celestial realms now echoed louder, urging them toward the climactic confrontation that would shape their destinies and the destiny of the divine artifact they sought. Chapter 3, Revelations in the Temple of Destiny. The celestial portal transported Alexios and his companions into the inner sanctum of Mount Olympus, a realm where the very essence of the gods resonated in the air. The Temple of Destiny, a hallowed sanctuary at the celestial summit, awaited them with celestial grandeur. The temple, carved from celestial stone and adorned with symbols of divine power, stood as a testament to the cosmic order that governed the affairs of gods and mortals. The fellowship, now attuned to the celestial energies, approached the temple with a sense of reverence. The entrance, guarded by ancient priestesses cloaked in robes woven from threads of the fates, exuded an aura of otherworldly wisdom. The priestesses, keepers of the cosmic tapestry, greeted the adventurers with nods that acknowledged the trials they had overcome and the celestial energy that pulsed within them. As they entered the temple, the air seemed to hum with the echoes of prophecies and the whispers of ancient deities. The walls were adorned with celestial frescoes, each depicting a chapter in the mythic saga of the gods. The celestial constellations above seemed to align with the images on the walls, creating a living narrative that unfolded with the resonance of destiny. The fellowship advanced through the inner sanctum, guided by the celestial glow that emanated from an altar at the heart of the temple. The altar, bathed in the radiance of divine energy, seemed to beckon them closer. As they approached, the priestesses began a ceremonial chant, their voices resonating with the cosmic harmonies that connected the celestial realms. In the presence of the altar, Alexios and his companions underwent mystical trials that transcended the boundaries of mortal understanding. Visions of the past, present, and future danced before their eyes, revealing the intricate web of fate that bound the gods to the mortal realm. The priestesses, conduits of celestial wisdom, guided them through the celestial visions, offering insights into the cosmic interplay that shaped the destinies of gods and mortals alike. The frescoes on the walls came to life, depicting the forging of the Bow of Zeus, the divine artisan Hephaestus shaping celestial metal, the fates weaving the threads of destiny around the bow, and Zeus infusing the weapon with the very essence of thunder and lightning. The celestial energies within the temple resonated with the creation of the legendary artifact, and Alexios, now a part of this cosmic narrative, felt the weight of his quest and the responsibility that came with wielding such power. The priestesses, with eyes that held the wisdom of ages, revealed the celestial alignments and cosmic events tied to the powers of the bow. The celestial dance of planets and constellations, the conjunctions that echoed through the celestial spheres, and the very threads of destiny that intertwined with the bow, all were unveiled in the tapestry of cosmic knowledge. The Fellowship, humbled by the revelations in the Temple of Destiny, discovered that their quest for the Bow of Zeus was not merely a pursuit of a powerful artifact, but a pilgrimage through the very heart of divine mysteries. The bow, now a symbol of cosmic significance, held the key to unlocking the threads of fate that bound the gods to the mortal realm. As they delved deeper into the inner sanctum, the priestesses unveiled the cosmic tapestry that connected Olympus to the mortal world. Prophecies, written in the language of the stars, foretold of a mortal champion who would wield the bow of Zeus and stand against celestial forces that sought to disrupt the cosmic harmony. Alexios, his name now inscribed in the celestial prophecies, felt the weight of destiny resting upon his shoulders. The climax of their revelations came at the Chamber of Celestial Reflections, a sacred space where the very fabric of reality seemed to ripple with the reflections of divine truths. The Fellowship, guided by the priestesses, gazed into celestial mirrors that unveiled the potential consequences of their quest. They witnessed the Celestial Guardian, a formidable entity forged from the essence of Olympus, standing vigil over the bow. The Celestial Guardian, an embodiment of thunder and lightning, towered over the celestial landscape. Its eyes sparkled with the wrath of Zeus, and its form crackled with celestial energy. The mirrors revealed the trials that awaited them, the elemental forces that the guardian would unleash, the celestial storms that would test their mettle, and the very essence of Zeus's power that coursed through the guardian's veins. Armed with the celestial insights gained in the Temple of Destiny, Alexios and his companions emerged with a newfound understanding of their quest. The Bow of Zeus was not only a weapon of divine might, but a catalyst for cosmic alignment. The Fellowship, united by destiny and cosmic knowledge, stood prepared to face the Guardian and unlock the powers of the legendary bow. As they exited the Temple of Destiny, the celestial energies resonated within them, and the priestesses bestowed upon them celestial artifacts, enchanted talismans that would enhance their abilities and attune them to the very forces that governed the celestial realms. Alexios, his heart now a beacon of celestial resonance, led the Fellowship toward the final confrontation with the Guardian. The celestial portal, shimmering with the energies of destiny, awaited them. Alexios and his companions, now bearing the weight of celestial insight and empowered by celestial artifacts, stepped through the portal, ready to face the Guardian and unlock the powers of the legendary bow of Zeus. The celestial summit, with its mythical creatures, mystic challenges, and revelations in the Temple of Destiny, had become the crucible that forged them into heroes destined to stand against the forces that guarded the essence of Olympus. The celestial call now echoed louder, propelling them toward the ultimate celestial confrontation that would shape their destinies and the destiny of the divine artifact they sought. Chapter 4, The Celestial Confrontation. The celestial portal transported Alexios and his companions to the precipice of a cosmic battleground, a realm where the very fabric of reality seemed to vibrate with the essence of Olympus. the guardian of the Bow of Zeus, awaited them. A formidable entity forged from the celestial energies that coursed through the veins of the King of Gods. The Fellowship, now bearing the celestial artifacts bestowed upon them in the Temple of Destiny, approached the guardian with a sense of determination and reverence. As they stepped onto the celestial summit, the air crackled with the energies of anticipation. The guardian, a towering embodiment of thunder and lightning, stood as a sentinel between the Fellowship and the legendary bow. Its eyes, infused with the wrath of Zeus, locked onto Alexios and his companions, and the very heavens seemed to echo the cosmic clash that was about to unfold. The guardian, sensing the celestial resonance within the adventurers, unleashed a torrent of elemental forces. Celestial storms, conjured from the very essence of Olympus, swirled around the summit, creating an otherworldly tempest. Bolts of celestial lightning arced through the cosmic skies, and thunder resonated like the very heartbeat of the gods. The Fellowship, empowered by the celestial artifacts, stood resolute amidst the celestial tumult. The battle that ensued was not merely physical, but a dance of cosmic forces. Alexios, with the celestial knowledge acquired in the Temple of Destiny, anticipated the guardian's movements, weaving between celestial bolts and countering with celestial strikes. Callista, her arrows enhanced by the celestial artifacts, unleashed volleys that mirrored the cosmic arrows of Artemis herself. The Fellowship, united by destiny and celestial empowerment, moved in harmony with the celestial energies that surged around them. The celestial storms intensified, their celestial fury reaching a crescendo that mirrored the very wrath of Zeus. As the guardian summoned celestial lightning, the Fellowship, now attuned to the cosmic dance, responded with celestial maneuvers. A celestial ballet unfolded, a clash of mortal determination against the elemental might of the gods. In the midst of the celestial confrontation, the guardian revealed its celestial form, a manifestation of Zeus's power and the very essence of celestial majesty. Its celestial visage, illuminated by the celestial storms, conveyed the cosmic struggle that echoed through the ages. Alexios, with the bow of Zeus within his reach, felt the very pulse of Olympus coursing through his veins. The Fellowship, guided by the celestial artifacts and celestial insights, aimed to disrupt the guardian's celestial equilibrium. Callista, with her celestial bow, targeted the celestial essence that bound the guardian to the cosmic energies. Alexios, wielding a celestial blade forged in the fires of Hephaestus, sought to sever the celestial connection that anchored the guardian to the very heart of Olympus. The celestial confrontation reached its zenith as the Fellowship, their celestial maneuvers coordinated with precision, struck at the core of the guardian's celestial essence. The guardian, now tested by the cosmic forces it had harnessed, wavered beneath the celestial onslaught. Celestial energies crackled around it, and the very summit seemed to echo the celestial clash that reverberated through the celestial realms. In a moment of celestial revelation, the guardian acknowledged the celestial prowess of the Fellowship. The celestial storms subsided, and the celestial lightning transformed into an ethereal radiance that enveloped the summit. The guardian, now bathed in celestial luminescence, bowed before Alexios, recognizing a mortal champion worthy of wielding the bow of Zeus. As the celestial tempest abated, the celestial summit transformed into a celestial sanctum, a realm where the boundaries between mortal and divine blurred. The guardian, now an ally rather than a foe, guided Alexios and his companions to the celestial pedestal upon which the legendary Bow of Zeus rested. The Bow of Zeus, infused with the very essence of the King of Gods, pulsed with celestial energy. Its celestial aura seemed to resonate with the celestial artifacts carried by the Fellowship, creating a celestial harmony that echoed through the cosmic expanse. Alexios, his hand steady and his spirit attuned to the celestial forces, approached the bow with a sense of destiny fulfilled. As he grasped the Bow of Zeus, the celestial energies within it recognized him as the celestial champion foretold in the prophecies. The bow, now an extension of his celestial prowess, glowed with a celestial radiance that surpassed mortal comprehension. The celestial essence within it seemed to align with the very heartbeat of Olympus, and the celestial artifacts carried by the Fellowship resonated in celestial unison. The celestial revelation, now complete, marked the culmination of Alexios's odyssey. The celestial summit, once a battleground, transformed into a celestial sanctuary where mortal and divine energies converged. The Fellowship, united by destiny and celestial empowerment, stood in the celestial glow, their reflections shimmering with the celestial resonance of the legendary bow. As they descended from the celestial summit, the celestial energies coursing through the Fellowship became a celestial beacon that reverberated through the celestial realms. The very air seemed to echo with the echoes of celestial triumph, and the Fellowship, now celestial champions, carried the Bow of Zeus as a celestial symbol of cosmic balance and destiny fulfilled. The tale of Alexios and the Bow of Zeus, now etched in the celestial annals, became a celestial saga that transcended the boundaries of mortal and divine. The celestial energies, once confined to the realm of myth, now coursed through the celestial lands, enriching the celestial tapestry of gods and mortals alike. Alexios, bearing the mantle of a celestial champion, led the Fellowship into a new celestial era. The Bow of Zeus, gleaming like a celestial guide, leaving behind a celestial legacy that echoed through the celestial realms and the celestial echoes of Olympus.